Avery, there seems to be a consensus that the Bank of Canada will hold at its April monetary policy meeting and start to cut rates in June. Is that what you're thinking? What does the bank need to see in these coming spring months to solidify that June cut?
So there's two pieces of the puzzle, one of which it already has plenty of information on, which is that the Canadian economy is struggling to get much growth with interest rates where they are. So they know that there's certainly a need, if we want the economy to start moving again, to lower interest rates. What they're waiting for is a bit more confirmation that inflation is under wraps. I think they'd like to see wages perhaps decelerate a bit more, and maybe a couple of more months like the last meeting we got on inflation that showed that, you know, other than rents and mortgage interest, you know, inflation is coming down and is likely to head towards the 2% they're looking for over time.
Let's unpack some of that. But before we get into that, though, most recently, the federal government announced that they are putting a cap on the number of temporary foreign residents. Tell us about the impact. You mentioned wages. Let's talk about how that will affect the labor market, how that's going to affect housing and Canada's economy.
So there is a bit of a win some, lose some in terms of the inflation implications of tempering down the number of temporary foreign workers. But on balance, I think it actually leans against inflation. Yes, there'll be some employers who have to pay up a little more to find people who are already in Canada to fill those jobs. But we do have more slack in the labor market at this point. People in other sectors are losing jobs. And on the plus side, rent inflation has been one of the stickiest items in the CPI. And it was really, you know, in large part, the surge of both temporary foreign workers and students that pushed up rents because those people tend to be renters. And the government initially announced they're paring back on the number of students. Now they're turning the attention to temporary foreign workers. And I think if we're patient, we'll see the reward for that in lower rent inflation when we look back at this a couple of years from now.
We've heard from the Bank of Canada that housing is a big piece in their monetary policy puzzle. What does this look like as rates start to come down? What is your forecast?
Well, perversely, you know, the housing inflation component is the one part where lower interest rates might actually help a bit. They're going to help lower the cost of mortgage renewals, which has been one big item in inflation. It's been running at over 20% in terms of that component of the CPI. But even for rental properties, if we take a longer term view here, high borrowing costs have stood in the way of some of the rental and condo construction that we would have seen in the past year. If we can bring interest rates down on mortgages for those sorts of properties, you know, not right away, but down the road, we'll have more housing supply, which will also help us on rent inflation. So this is the one part of the CPI where if we can see enough sluggishness in inflation and the other components, we can help get that last mile of getting CPI comfortably at 2% by actually cutting interest rates, stimulating a bit more home building in the process and creating some supply of rental properties.
You also mention the dose in your most recent CIBC note. What kind of interest rate dose is the Bank of Canada going to have to inject to get the economy moving?
So I remember the Rolling Stones song, you can't always get what you want, but you get what you need. And in this case, relative to the U.S. economy, the Canadian economy is certainly showing that it needs more in the way of interest rate cuts. You know, we haven't seen any material slowing in the U.S. economy to this point, even though their interest rates are a bit higher than Canada's. And so we're crying out a bit more for some real interest rate relief. So I don't think a 0.5% or 1% is going to do the trick. My guess is that by the end of 2025, for example, we're going to need to see those short-term interest rates down around 3%, maybe even a shade lower, to get the economy moving. That's still not low by the standards of where we were prior to the pandemic. Back then, the highest interest rate we saw in the last business cycle was an overnight rate of 1.75%. I don't think we're going to need that much relief, because we haven't fallen into a deep recession here. But we're going to need a significant reduction in interest rates to get the economy moving again once inflation is under control.
Let's just talk about that, because you also mentioned the economic squeeze in your note. And we know that it's been a very different story south of the border and here in Canada when it comes to the two economies. What are you going to be watching for as rates come down throughout the year? Give us a look ahead.
I think what we're going to see is that rates come down faster in Canada than the U.S., and that largely reflects the differences between what Americans are feeling and what Canadians have been feeling. We owed more money as a household sector in Canada than Americans did, partly because our houses got so expensive, we took on big mortgages to buy them relative to what Americans were spending in terms of the share of their income. And then, unlike the U.S., we don't have mortgages locked in for 30 years, so we're renewing those mortgages at higher rates, whereas only an American that moves really faces those much higher mortgage rates. So the squeeze on Canada's household sector has been much more material. That's shown up in a big difference in consumer spending, which has been quite brisk in the U.S. until the last couple of months, at least, and in Canada, quite subdued really over the last couple of years. And so we're going to need more interest rate relief. And I think that's what we'll get. We'll get a sharper decline in interest rates in Canada than in the U.S. over the next couple of years. And that will help provide Canadians with that extra relief that they need, given their higher debt level.